From the elements palette on the left side, I choose a transmission line and I drag it, and I want to attach it to the right of the structure. Notice in the layout now how when I place this transmission line, it automatically shows up in the layout. And this is due to the auto synchronization mode that I have selected. Now notice that the line I added in the layout is a thick line, M1 plus M2. It has two layers with a via. So in order to change it to the M2, I click on it, and then I use the icon on the toolbar, so automatically it will change it to a one layer M2. And from this window, I can change its width to match with the line just preceding it. Next, let me delete this layout completely, and I would like to illustrate to you the second synchronization method between schematic and layout in ADS. So from the options, preferences, I choose single representation between schematic and layout. In this mode, designers have full flexibility to place the items wherever they like on the layout page from the schematic. So let me illustrate this to you. If we go to layout on the top and we click on place components from schematic to layout, it automatically notice opens a small window that says design differences, which is like an LVS check. It indicates to you what is in the schematic page that is not on the layout page. So all these components here are not on the layout page, and we need to place them. And also notice in the schematic there is that red outline, which tells you that all these red outlines are not on the layout page. So we take one by one. We take the first transmission line, we lay it out, and notice the red lines are disappearing. Here's the via, here's another transmission line, and notice as I place it, the red lines are disappearing. Not only that, look at the right side on the window, the design differences. You notice the green check marks on the top indicating that these items have been placed in the layout and we still have more to go. So I keep doing this. I place every component from the schematic to the layout page. And as I finish, notice the red outlines on the schematic is gone. And notice the design differences table on the top left has all green checks telling me that everything has been placed from the schematic page to the layout page. Next, let me delete the layout again from the layout page in order to illustrate to you another mode of the single representation, a synchronization between schematic and layout. So from the layout pull-down menu, I pick Generate Update Layout. A window pops out asking me where would you like the synchronization to start. So I choose the left side, the beginning of my structure, I hit OK, and in one stroke I have the whole structure generated in the layout page. So to recap, I showed you that ADS has three different synchronization modes between schematic and layout, including the always design synchronized mode. The single representation is very flexible, so designers can place their components anywhere they would like in the layout, giving them total flexibility. Now let us go back to the layout page and use the toolbar to look at our structure using the 3D viewer. So from the toolbar we click on the open 3D viewer icon, and here's the 3D view of our structure in the 3D viewer. So with the proper zooming and settings, you can inspect that structure in the 3D view. So you can see if the layers are connected through the via or if there is any opens. So here we see the M1 and M2 lines connected through a via between the two layers. And for bigger and multi-layer structure, it helps you to look vertically at all the layers and all the connections. So this concludes my demo. I hope you have enjoyed it. Thank you very much for watching.